देर को बैठे थी 12 मिनट है
सर वी विल बिगिन दिस बाय लुकिंग एट द इवेंट्स इन दिल्ली थ्रू द आईज ऑफ नॉट मेन नॉट वुमेन वी विल बिगिन बाय लुकिंग एट दिस थ्रू द आईज ऑफ चिल्ड्रन Two brothers went missing for days. Their bodies were later found in a drain. A 10-year-old saw people carrying guns and swords and firing, and he was scared. Three children of a man in uniform lost their father. We've all seen the picture of a girl bashed against the wall. She was left bleeding. Sir, these are deep scars of violence which have left children damaged. We were looking for answers for the last 12 days, not to have a debate on who won political points. We were looking for the 3 R's. We were looking for healing, for relief, for rehabilitation, for reconciliation. These children were looking for answers. And I'm afraid what we heard in Lok Sabha yesterday or this political rhetoric we heard, we gave no answers to these children. If you tell them 36 hours or 700 FIRs or 12 meetings or 1984, these are not the answers, sir. Where are the answers? Because the children of India believe that you're only half a home minister if you are an HM. The children of India want you to believe and make you a full home minister if you're HM, a home minister and a humanity minister. And for that, you need to feel the humanity. Sir, today, I'm hearing people who quote Gandhi but worship Godse. But today, I would like to remind people, today is a significant day because on this day, 90 years ago, Gandhiji started the salt satyagraha. And through you, sir, I want to give some advice. I want to give some advice to the Home Minister who I heard with great attention yesterday. Because how did he react to this carnage in Delhi? And he explained to us that he couldn't go there because there would be police going and people going and it'll distract everybody. So I want to take him back on this special day of Gandhiji to 1946. How did Gandhiji react? This was at Nohakali in East Bengal. He walked 10 kilometers, he stayed there for 3 months, and he said, and I quote, "I am not leaving this place until the last embers are stamped out. If necessary, I will die there." So those were different days. Everything we are saying today is how do we do this because we can win an election. Sir, elections cannot be the be-all and the end-all of life because we all know there's enough data to suggest which is the one political party which benefits after these kind of things happen. But I don't want to go there, sir. I want to start by quoting what Mamata Banerjee, the Chief Minister of Bengal, said days after this happened, hours, quote, "The way people have been murdered in Delhi, it is a planned genocide. I condemn it." Again, to these children, these words won't make any difference. Whether you call it a genocide, a riot, a pogrom, a carnage, it doesn't make a difference. Genocide. Actually, genocide is a process. And we need to understand this. If you look back at history, genocide did not start with the gas chambers. Zoop, and you got gas chambers. No. If you look at the first genocide of 1905 or the World War II, it started with inciting slogans. And I want to draw a difference here without getting into any of the slogans. You use inciting slogans in Bengal, you will be arrested in 24 hours. 9 were arrested in Delhi. 9. We don't want to get arrested here because then one or two members from here also have to go. Now the way these slogans were made, the way the bigotry was spread, the way the hate was spread, it is very difficult to believe that does not have the sanction from the top. And what happens here? The police have to be complicit. I go back to my Second World War story, because the Gestapo and the German police, they were all part of the overall plan. The Delhi police for 36 hours or 72 hours, we are saying this with responsibility, were turned off. Then they were turned on again. I don't want to make, not that the Delhi police is a bad police force. I'm sure there are many brave men there. The Prime Minister takes his time, 70 hours. But I want to congratulate the people who did do a good job. Young boys and girls below 30 from the Indian media. I salute their courage. I salute their conviction, because putting their own life at risk, handling a government with an absolute majority and a totalitarian view of life, they still went there and showed courage and conviction. And through you, sir, today, I want to appeal to those media owners to stand up and show the same courage and conviction which your young reporter showed. Don't be scared of them. No. Stand up. Be encouraged. Because today, I also want young India to take a look at the pictures of a judge when he's transferred from Delhi. Look at those pictures. You don't need a single word more to say. Enough said. It's another matter, then you'll also get threatened in one floor of the house. Where are we headed, sir, today? Of course, these governments has achievements. And as an opposition party, we must acknowledge these achievements. And they are big achievements. Pogrom, lynchings, a completely torn social fabric, a ravaged economy with failing banks, job losses, damaged international standing, subverted institutions, and fallen democratic norms. Sir, for the healing touch, what can we as a political party do? In our small way, we opened up a benevolent fund. We are trying to find out how, you know, to reach the right people. Because it's not about 55 dead only. There are thousands who are homeless, who are scared to go back to their homes. Tell us, Mr. Home Minister, how will you heal? How will you reconcile? When we've been asking for this debate in Parliament for the last 10 days, after the weekend, you'll come back. We were not here to accuse you of what you can do or what you can't do or what happened in 1984. No. I have a few direct questions also, because I think this is a time for healing. This is a time for reconciling. But this is also a time to ask some hard questions. We were talking yesterday, we heard from the Home Minister, all social media accounts, one, that spread hate speeches will be brought to book. Mr. Prime Minister, Mr. Home Minister, you start. You are our Prime Minister and Home Minister. Lead by example. First, stop following all those handles which are spreading bigotry and hate. Tell us today on the floor of the House. Assure us. Assure those children in Delhi. You've said Delhi police have a good job. Then I want to ask you, if the Delhi police did so well, why was the chain of command superseded and the NSA deployed? Answer this question today on the floor of the House. Because, or is the new role of the NSA to control riots? My third one is, you've suddenly stopped talking about CAA, CAA, CAA. I've been watching your last few speeches. Now you've stopped about NRC. So don't, you've stopped talking about NRC. I haven't said you stopped doing NRC. We've been warning you from before. The CAA, the NRC, and the NPR together are a toxic combination. Fourth one, we understand that the police need facial recognition to do their job for national security. But are you using technology to identify people in a crowd? Did you admit yesterday on the floor of the House that people's personal data is being used to identify them? And sir, now to come to one of the core areas of my, and the last one, sir, one question. Can you assure on the floor of Parliament, because it's like the doctor, the patient has died, then you said this pressure was wrong, that pressure was wrong, there are 50 people who are dead. Who is responsible? The Home Minister has to take responsibility. There's no other way. The Prime Minister has to be responsible. Assure this House that this will not be a second carnage, so we don't have to quote 1984, then now 2002. Now let me come to this 2000. Did I say 2002?
Yeah.
It's the same thing, actually. It's the same thing. It's 2002. You flip one number around, it's 2020. It's the same thing. It's the blood on the hands. It's the same man. It's the same innocent blood. It's the same sadness. It's the same trauma. It's the same trauma. It's the same cover-up. It's the same model. It is, sir. Gid ki sarkar, lashon ka karobar. That's the way it is, sir. And people know this. Sir, we want deep reconciliation. We want the heals to be, we want the wounds to be healed. Sir, let me end by Bangla boli Kazi Nojrul Islamir kotha. Duletiche tori, fuliteche jol, buliteche majipot, chiriache pal, ke dhori bohal, ache kar himmot. Abar boli sir. Duliteche tori, fuliteche jol, buliteche majipot, chiriache pal, ke dhori behal, ache kar himmot. এখানে তো কারুর হিম্মত দেখছি না স্যার এখন আমার কথাই নজরুলের নয় আছে আছে একজন যেখানে ইউনিটি ইন ডাইভার্সিটি যেখানে হয় where we actually see unity in diversity we can find the answer there sir কোথায় দেখতে হবে বাংলার গর্ব মমতা this is The boat rocks, the ocean swells, the boatman's lost his bearings, the sails are ripped, who will now take the helm? Who has the daring? Thank you, sir.
Thank you.